What is up, guys? I am back. Last time I played A&M against Ohio State and they kicked the snot out of me, so I am going to try again. I'm a little sore this morning. I do submission wrestling. I don't know if you guys, it's like jiu-jitsu, but I mean it is jiu-jitsu, but jiu-jitsu is like it's a little bit confusing because there's so many grappling arts. But anyway, I did that last night and I haven't been there in a week because of the weather down here. So it definitely hurts when you're not doing it consistently. I don't know if you guys do any kind of martial arts or anything like that. It's really good for self-esteem. Like it's really good because you, for people that kind of doubt themselves and feel like they can't, like they're not really good at anything. Something like jiu-jitsu or just any kind of wrestling helps build up that confidence because there's a certain thing about knowing that if you really had to, you could probably mess somebody up. That's what I did last night. And I thought about going this morning, but I wasn't feeling it, and I thought I'd just hit a little bit of a stream today. Oh, there's a fumble.
Can't be happy with the way the running back is
I was thinking
handled after
about
carrying the
starting
ball.
a dynasty, but I've tried that before and I'm just a little inconsistent with it. I don't even know if people would like really watch it.
Attack is hard to defend. Sometimes you've got everybody covered and they still bust out on a nice gain on you.
You're right, Lee. When this offense is on, they're very hard to stop.
Looks like they're in the ace formation. I'm gonna stick to nickel. Cover two.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Number 13, alone in the backfield.
I do want to start a dynasty. But I'm kind of debating whether I want to just stream it live or pre-record it and then edit it. There's a really cool YouTuber, I forget his name, but he does dynasties, but he edits them and he makes them like stories. There's probably several YouTubers that do that, but I thought that was pretty cool that he could make something that is a little mundane and then turn it into a story. So I thought about doing that. Maybe I'll try that. I don't know. I do know that it's very time consuming. It's not like just live streaming a game real quick. Looks like they're staying in that ace formation.
It's first and 10, and this is the sixth play of the drive. One man back for you. Here's the option left. He's into the open field. Makes a pitch.
Last time I played Ohio State, I threw like four interceptions, or like three interceptions and one fumble. So this time around, I have to be very, very cautious with how I throw the ball. Because I can run the ball pretty good, but as soon as I start airing it out, I kind of start putting myself into a hole. And I've had games where I throw the ball 0 times. I believe that's what you call an unbalanced offense.
Wait, these guys fast or what? Good job of penetrating and getting to the ball carrier here.
Second and 11 coming up. Ball on the 31-yard line. Texas A&M lines up with five defensive backs. He drops back. He steps up. Watch the middle. Incomplete. And he's thrown in the direction of the tight end.
Right, we got third down coming up. Third and 11. That should help us out. Those 11 yards. I think I'm going to go dime. Dog gold. Get a little extra pressure on the QB here with the fifth man. I don't think I've ever seen a blocked punt in this game. It's basically automatic. Like if you're in range and you hit it at the right accuracy, I mean, I've never seen a blocked punt.
So.
First play, HB slam, always.
They'll take over at the 22. They line up in a double tight set.
I'm looking at that left side of the line. Looks like it's pretty good. And he broke through.
They'll drop him for a loss. Didn't get anything. It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 22. Texas A&M comes to the line. Only one man in the backfield. Here's the option. Lateral's back. And he's going to lose yards on this one. Loss of three. Third and 13 coming up. Ball on the 19-yard line.
Let's see what we got here.
With three wide receivers. Drop back to pass. Looking. Scrambling around. Going deep. Lays it up there.
Perfect.
He's all the way down. 46. The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. The Buckeyes line up with six defensive backs.
Number 83 looks like he has a pretty good route there.
They'll throw on first down. He's looking. Watch the middle.
Oh my God.
And it's picked off. And this one could be on the defense.
Pass interference. On the defense. Spot foul. First down.
Moving forward.
Thank God I get the ball back.
Anytime you can get 3 yards, you'll take it.
Let's go back to the ground.
First and 10.
Before we just start throwing it everywhere.
The Aggies go with the I formation. They go with the run. And he's taken down. A 5-yard pickup for the tailback. It's second down and 5 to go. This is the fifth play of this drive. Number one is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Hit left. And down he goes. A pickup of 4.
I saw them shift to the left. I don't know if you saw that. They shifted to the left. And if I would have kept running to the left, they would have tackled me. But there was a hole. So I ran straight up it. Sometimes I don't see those reads, but when I do, I catch them.
Texas A&M comes out with an I formation. He's got an opening. Gets past the tackler. He's not got a mile. Again, they're able to move the sticks on third down.
And I'm going to tell you what. This offense has put together one impressive drive. We'll see if they can dish it off with a score.
Texas A&M sets up in the eye. Here's the give. And he's taken down. 4 yard gain by the back. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 15-yard line. They line up in an eye. On the ground with the tailback. And down he goes. The halfback gets a couple there on the counter.
Slow and steady. I am 4 yards away, so I'm kind of weary about doing another run play. I could probably get this wide receiver drag play going.
And two for two on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here. Number 25 lines up in the deep back, I formation.
That's it, touchdown.
He takes off.
That was a nice play. Let's see what happened. Both my receivers on the right side had routes going to the left side of the field, and they had no safeties over there. No safeties. Number six here, I was watching him to make sure he got picked up. Sometimes they'll pursue this way instead of straight down. So that worked out. And then nothing but green.
And he tacks on the extra point. With just over a minute to go in the first quarter, the score is Texas A&M 7, Ohio State 3. Texas A&M is ready to kick it away. Number 7 and number 28 set to return. Number 28 takes it at the 4. The offense ready to go again as their last drive ended with 3 points.
All right. If I can hold them to at least a touchdown, I mean, at least a field goal here,
set up shot at the 20.
I should be able to start getting ahead of them.
Number 13 is the single setback. Pitch left. And he's taken down. 3 yard gain by the running back. Second and 7 coming up here. Ball on the 26. Number 13 alone in the backfield. Back to pass. He's going left.
Oh.
And they do a good job at swatting that one away.
He would have caught that. That would have been another touchdown right there.
To know where the football is and just get his hand on it.
That would have been room service, actually. Seven.
Steps up in the pocket. And it's caught. Knocked out of bounds.
That's behind the line. The marker.
Yeah, they just didn't get enough yardage on that pass.
No surprise here as they prepare to punt it away. Punts the ball away. number two. Fields it to 31. Picked up some good solid yardage on that return.
Yo, that's not good for the old net punting average either.
They'll go to work at the 45-yard line. Texas A&M lines up in a double tight set. On the ground with a tailback. Sheds that one.
Uh-oh.
First and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. They line up in an eye. They hand off on the counter. He tries to spin. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. The
defensive line. I'm trying to follow my fullback here. But he went way out there. There goes this guy. Oh no, he got blocked. 47 somehow breaks off of 98 here.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 35-yard line. Number 25, the lone back. Back to pass. Under pressure. He's on the run. He's going to take off. And down he goes at the 28.
Just gets clothesline. But he's tough. He'll get up.
And that'll be the end of the first quarter with our score. Texas A&M, 7. Ohio State, 3. It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 28. The Buckeyes bring in their dime package. Drops back to pass. Look, throw short, complete.
Get out of my way.
A nice completion that time.
Good completion. And I don't know if you guys noticed or not, but that was exactly the same play they just ran. They're not very creative in their play calling.
Creative? You don't need to be creative with these kind of results.
Ohio State lines up in a dime defense here. Here's the give. And down he goes. A 5-yard pickup for the tailback.
I actually like this formation a lot. The ace spread formation.
Texas A&M.
Because it's really easy to read. Like right now, it's 6 in the box against my 5. Typically, that wouldn't be a successful run, but I was able to get to the outside.
A 7-yard run by the running back. The Aggie with 4 receivers. He'll get the call again, and they hit him in the backfield.
He let that little corner bring him down. To be a productive runner at the college level, you have to make that guy miss and get upfield.
The Aggies line up with four.
Gotta be really careful here.
He drops back.
Fire. They blitzed.
And he's taken down.
And right on the goal line.
Yeah, he had great position there. And that ball was thrown in the right spot.
See if I can just go straight up the middle. Power against power. Strength against strength. Let's go. Got it.
Guys, what do you think of that touchdown?
Well, I really like the way the line made room for this guy to run through. I like the way he used his vision there to run through the hole. This offense is really clicking right now.
They line up to punt this one away. They tried to grab
what?
A conversion, but came up short.
What did I do? I punted the ball? Okay. Weird. I didn't even know I did that. Just, okay. Give up an extra point, okay. Like how it said 2-point conversion. Like, how are you gonna score on a 2-point conversion off of a punt? Number seven fields it at the two. Maybe if somehow the defender touches it and then you score in the end zone. Two men in the backfield, I'll go to 4-3, cover two man.
They'll get the ball here at the 20. Ohio State lines up with a split backfield. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Not across the middle. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He needed a little more touch on his throw.
He's got to take a deep breath, relax, and just play that pitch and catch out there. Don't be anxious, kid.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line. Drop back pass. Steps up. He's looking down the middle.
Get him.
And down he goes. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but
third and 4.
Solid yardage.
They go on goal line. Yes, they are. Let's see. I don't want to go goal line here. I'll go 4-4.
They come out in a goal line set. Drops back to pass. Throws it to the outside.
Dang it.
And he's taken down. Wow, how about that third down conversion?
Boy, what a play here, guys. I'm really impressed with the poise of this young quarterback. He was very cool and collected
well,
out there on that third and long play.
If I was in goal line, I probably wouldn't have even had a man out there. I guess I'm lucky.
First and 10. Ball on 34. Number 13 lines up as a single back. Pressure comes.
Hit him.
Slip right through a crack in the line and get a big sack.
It's second down now, 13 to go.
Let's keep this pressure up on the quarterback.
The Buckeye line up in a split back.
Second and 13. Get him. Got him. Two sacks in a row.
They put the pressure on and it paid off.
But his protection just simply broke down, and if that continues, this quarterback's gonna have a long day.
Third and 17. Same play. Let's go. Get him. 3 sacks in a row. Those maroon goons are just too much, man. Too much. The wrecking crew.
The special teams coach sends his punt team out on the field. He gets it off. Number 2 takes it at the 43. Hardly tough sledding for this offense that last drive as they took it in for 6.
Now look no further than the guys up front. They created some huge holes to run through.
They'll take over at the 49. Texas A&M comes out with 2 tight ends. And down he goes at the 50-yard line. A 1-yard gain on the play. Second and 9 coming up here. Ball on the 50. Number 16 with 4 wide receivers. Throw short.
Oh, man.
That would have been a tough Let's take another look at that play.
Third and nine.
Ball on the 50.
Go deep.
The Buckeyes bring in the nickel package. Drop back to pass. He scrambled.
We'll get this first down. Kind of like to save the QB scrambles for third down situations. Because after a while, if you just do it over and over again, I mean, the defense eventually catches on. So QB scrambles in this game are a little bit higher percentage, but not if you just do them all the time or back to back. You gotta know when to mix it up. No challenges. Keep forgetting I'm not playing 2K5. Gasol. Was it 83 over here? Yeah, 83. This had the potential for a touchdown. I mean, if 3 and 5 blocked their guys over there, he was wide open, but too much pressure. Keep the pressure on the QB. We got 3 sacks last drive.
Tell you what, fellas, I love this kid's throwing ability. He's got a quick release and he's very accurate.
First and 10, ball on the 40-yard line. The Buckeyes come out in the ace formation. Here's the option.
Oh, he missed both of them.
And he's taken down. That's a gain of 8.
Come on, 49. What were you doing? Or was he faked out by that fake pitch? Maybe that's what that was.
Second and 2 coming up here. Ball on the 32-yard line. Ace backfield.
I don't get what the difference here is. Bucks ball, 3rd and 1 on 32. Okay.
These guys right now are just helping out the opposition.
Yeah, those mistakes drive a coach crazy. Lack of discipline on the field hates it.
Going goal line again.
It's 3rd down, 2 to go. Ball number 32. The Buckeyes come to the line with their jumbo package. They hand it off. And down he goes. And they get a nice gain on 3rd down.
Remember, we talked to the coach, and he mentioned that he wanted to run the ball against this defense, and he felt that he may have some success. Well, they've had some success on that front.
1st and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Single set back to you. They'll throw on 1st down. Steps up. Watch the throw outside. And he's caught. And he's taken down at the 17. The Buckeyes call for a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. And there's 2 minutes remaining in the half. The Buckeyes line up in a split back set. They're going to pitch it.
Dang. All the way up there. It's all right. They'll probably get their extra point. That'll bring them to 10-13. We'll have almost 2 minutes to score. At least a field goal. Stay ahead. Got all three timeouts too.
Things here, guys. First, you have to call a play that allows your offense to get more than they did there. And second, you got to make more of a concerted effort to get to the sidelines in that situation to stop the clock.
Boy, you're absolutely right. That was not a good play any way you slice it.
Single set back to you.
That was a mistake.
And he stopped behind the line.
Third and 10.
Receivers lined up here, set to go to the air. He's looking. Now he tries to buy some time.
We'll take that.
He keeps it. He's got a lot of green. And he's taken down at the 46-yard line.
Phew, that was close.
Third down.
You know, we're always talking about the importance of converting on third down. If you're going to have any kind of success, you got to be able to keep these drives alive, like they did right there.
First and 10. Ball on their own 46. Number 16 with four wide receivers. Across the middle. Complete.
First down.
First down. What a pass.
Boy, that was a big time throw by the quarterback. He did a good job of taking what the defense gives him.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 43. Number 16 has four receivers lined up here. And he's taken down. And he didn't get out of bounds.
Call a timeout here.
Will continue to run.
Yeah, good job of wrapping him up there.
Five coming up here. This is the sixth play of this drive. Ohio State brings in their nickel package. He's under pressure. Big opening. And down he goes. That was a nice pickup.
And that middle opened up like the Red Sea.
He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
Whoop, right there.
First and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line. Ace backfield. And he's taken down at the 23. They need to do a better job of managing the clock here.
You're right, Fred. Not only was that a horrible play in terms of yards picked up, but also, as you mentioned, in terms of
I need to be passing it right now.
Second and 9. Ball on the 23. The Aggies line up with three wide. He drops back. Looks down the middle. His receiver.
There it is. Touchdown. Perfect pass. Now let's actually kick a field goal this time.
Number 7 and number 28 back deep to return.
I'm going to work in a 3-4 here just to keep a little bit more coverage in the backfield, in the secondary. Interception. Yeah. I think about dime, actually.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 29.
Make sure we don't lose track of anybody.
The Aggies bring in their dime package. On the ground with the tailback. Can't wrap him up.
Somebody get him. Jesus.
No, it really was, Brad. And also a nice read by the ball carrier to find.
They're gonna spike it.
The Buckeyes are gonna take a timeout,
okay.
And that was their last timeout.
They do a hurry up and then they time out. Oh, they're gonna Hail Mary. Not a bad first half.
And that'll do it for the first
10-20. I might go for two later in the game, depending on what happens, but I might not have to. Let's see some of these stats here. So I have 3 more first downs than they do. Almost double the total offense. Almost double the rushing yards. Less passing, of course. Well, less attempts, but more yards. Yeah, 3 sacks all on one drive. Perfect third down conversion. For some reason, I punted on an extra point, which made it a 2-point conversion. So that's what that is. 1 turnover. And 1 fumble. Oh yeah, I was looking for 1 interception on their side, but I forgot that it was called back. So I only lost... got a turnover from the fumble. See how the QBs are doing. 255.9 rating. 5 out of 6, 84 yards. Almost perfect. Now, one of the reasons that I switched the clock time, the quarters, I started out at 5-minute quarters, but I bumped it up to 8. So 3 more minutes every quarter should get a little bit more realistic stats. And I think it looks a little bit better. Seven out of 13. That's not too bad, right? For half a football game, 13 attempts. So number 59 here, you got 2 sacks. And tackles for loss. Seems like 49 and 59 are the ones getting all the good tackles. All right, let's get this second half on. Let's start the second half.
We're ready to start the second half. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. Number three fields it in the end zone.
Well, my blockers went this way. I don't know why.
And it would have been wise to take a knee in that situation.
Yeah, but when you're yeah probably.
All that adrenaline pumping, you always think you got a chance to break one.
I'm going to stick to my game. Just run for a couple yards. And throw the occasional pass to keep the defense on its feet.
He's gobbled up in the backfield. So he's tackled for a loss by the linebacker. It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 9-yard line. Texas A&M sets up in the eye. And he's taken down at the 14. A 5-yard gain. Now it's 3rd and 6 coming up. Ball on their own 14. The Buckeye line up with 6 defensive backs. He drops back. Looking. Wants the middle. His receiver has it. They convert.
I knew number 5 was the guy.
How about the timing on that route, coach? Yeah, Kirk, the quarterback was able to throw to a spot, and the receiver was there to catch it for a 1st and 10. Nice play.
Number 1 lines up in the deep back, eye formation. They go with the run.
Get him away.
At the 29-yard line, he rumbles ahead and picks up about 5. 2nd down and 5. This is the 5th play of this drive. Number 1 is a deep back as they line up in the eye. Play action. He's looking. He's
that was stupid.
How about that?
He's got to come up with that catch here.
Yeah, you're right. I should have was throw the pass behind him. That would have been a perfect situation for that. Go.
Faces another 3rd down as they line it up. Ohio State comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Looks. Almost intercepted.
Threw it off my back foot. Didn't lead the receiver. Dang it.
Decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing.
Yeah, but that defender had a perfect shot at it. He just didn't catch it.
Well, if they score next drive, I'm still 3 points ahead.
Number 7 fields it at the 27. And he got a few yards.
He got more than a few. That was a good return.
Good return and outstanding speed. He almost went all the way that time.
Take over at the 38. They'll throw on 1st down. Steps up across the middle. His receiver has it.
Somebody get him.
There's a missed tackle.
Please.
And he's all the way down to the 28. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does. And he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
And 10. Ball on the 28. There's the play fake.
Got him. Is that 59 again? Oh, number 99.
And they're really, really fast, too.
Well, this speed is difficult to defend because you have to try to keep them off balance so they can't use their quickness.
They're going 5 wide. I'll go to dime. Cover 2.
It's 2nd down, 15 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Texas A&M has all their DBs in for this 5-wide set. He just let his wide.
Looks like he just threw it down to the ground. Okay. Setting up third down here. Third down and 15. I'm gonna go to nickel. I'll go cover two.
Third down, 15, ball in the 33. The Buckeyes come out short three wide. Drop back to pass. He steps up. Home run ball in the air.
That's nowhere. Got it. Well, I was expecting him to score, so 3 points is pretty good. Not what I wanted to do. Keep forgetting what the kneel button is. Right now we can go real slow. Milk the clock.
They'll start this drive at the 20-yard line. Number one lines up in the deep back, I formation. They get it out there on the top. Broke away from one, and he's taken down. The halfback got about 7 yards there on the pitch.
I'm running to the right almost 60% in this game.
Texas A&M comes out with an I formation. He drops back. Complete. And down he goes. Nice little catch there, huh, Coach?
Yeah, that was a good call. I like that call. I like short passes. They're safe and can lead to some really good yardage.
It's first and 10.
I'm going to try this reverse play, see what happens. Might just get stuffed in the backfield.
Line up in an I formation. Reverses it.
That was stupid. Too many guys down there.
They're going the wrong way, Coach.
Hey, Brad, if you don't have offensive balance, you can't.
That was dumb.
Off of you.
Second and long. Ball on 24. The Aggies go with the I formation. They go with the toss. Bounces off the would-be tackle.
Some of those yards back.
Seven to go, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. Texas A&M sets up in the eye.
Looking for a short pass from the halfback, maybe the tight end.
Back to pass. Looking. He rolls out to the left. Across the middle, and it falls incomplete. Now, who's the penalty going to be called out here?
That was stupid. But I'll take the pass interference call. Don't mind if I do.
As you know, as long as the defenders look,
I think I waited too long that pass. Maybe if I would have threw it behind the tight end, but that looks like a prime spot for 37 to jump out and catch that. Halfback was covered. I probably could have threw it behind him. Could have done that. I think everybody else was covered. I didn't really see number five over here yet. Too far away. Well, I got a lucky break. I'm gonna keep it back on the ground.
Second down and 8 to go. This is the 6th play of this drive. Texas A&M comes out with an I formation. He laterals the ball. Spinning. down he goes at the 43. 4, maybe 5 yards on the run.
I'm going to go straight up the gut here.
This is the seventh play of the current drive. Texas A&M sets up in the eye. Inside
handoff. Dang, I shouldn't have bounced that to the right. Shouldn't have done that.
That time they came with the blitz and caused enough confusion up front, they were able to get to it.
Six, awaiting the return. Didn't get all of that one.
I shanked that punt, man.
At the 40. A good job on their last drive, getting three. Let's see if they can get some more on this drive. They'll get the ball here at the 40-yard line. The Buckeyes come out in the ace formation. Inside handoff, and he's taken down at the 41-yard line. 1 yard on the play. It's second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 41. He'll get the call again.
It's a good tackle, good tackle.
30, 3rd and 7.
I'll go cover 2 again.
3rd down and 7. Ball on the 43-yard line. High formation here. Here's a pitch, left side.
I knew they were gonna toss it out to the left.
This kid tell him not to throw to his side. He's telling him not to run to his side.
They send out the punting unit. Number 21 gets it off. Number 2 fields it at the 17. A good return there, guys.
I'll tell you what, the blocking was tremendous on that play, coach. You're absolutely right. He made some good moves, but the blocking was solid.
I'll try a play action first down. See if I can't throw it down the field.
The Aggies come out in a 2 tight end set. Setting up the play action. He's looking. Now he's scrambling. No one open, so he's gonna run. They'll get 2 on that.
I was gonna throw it, but I didn't see anybody open, so I'll just take the 2 yards.
It's 2nd down and 8. Ball on the 36. Texas A&M comes out with 2 tight ends. Handoff up the middle. Nothing doing. Tackled for a loss on the play. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
It's 3rd down and 8 to go. Ball on their own 36.
3rd and 8.
Ohio State lines up with 5 defensive backs.
This is a toss play, so probably not going to go very far.
And they got him for a loss.
Keep the clock moving, I guess.
Shoot through the line right into the backfield. That play didn't have a chance.
I'm gonna wait these 15 seconds.
No surprise here as they prepare to punt it away.
Gotta get as close to the end of the third as possible.
It's away and it's a booming punt. Number 7 takes it to 21. Not a whole lot of success their last time out.
Not at all. This offense has to do a better job of staying on the field and giving their defense a chance to catch their breath.
38. The defense will stack the line of scrimmage. Fullback straight ahead. He gets a tackle, and he's taken down. The fullback picks up about 3 yards on that carry. Second and seven. Ball on the 41-yard line. And that's the end of the third quarter. Our score in this one.
All right, fourth quarter coming up. I'm up by 7. And defense is doing pretty well.
Second and 7 coming up here. Ball on their own 41.
Very well, actually.
The Buckeyes line up with 3 wide. Up the middle. He spins around. And down he goes. 4-yard gain by the back.
Third and 3. There's not many plays in 4-4 defense. Of course. Somebody get him.
And they finally push him out at the 22-yard line. And that run will give him 100 for the game.
The old head coach has to be happy with the running game today.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line.
Got a blitz here.
Drop back to pass. He's going to air it long.
Almost intercepted that one.
They're really fortunate to still have a shot at points.
This is one of the prettiest passes I've ever seen.
I think I'm just going to keep on blitzing here. He seemed to be doing pretty well on the ground. But if I can get enough pressure on the QB, that should help things.
Again with a carry. And he's taken down. 4-yard pickup by the fullback. The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. Linebackers come in tight.
Get him. Smack that down, man. Yeah. All right. I think they're going to go for it here. Yeah. Go back to 4-3. Go back to Raider 2. Fourth and 6.
They're going to try to convert this one.
I'm guessing they're going to pass it.
He drops back. Steps up in the pocket.
And they got it.
Spins upfield.
Took a chance and a loss.
This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the
penalty. Got a flag. Let's see what it is.
Got an inverted face mask on the defense.
They got a little bit of help there.
Yeah, they sure did. They'll gladly take anything this defense is going to give them out there.
Let's see if they can punch this one in. You'll get the call again.
Somebody get him, jeez.
How do you like that? They give it to the fullback.
I like that. I like that a lot. That's a good call around the goal line. And there's no way the defense will stop that guy. He's going to get in the end zone no matter what. He was determined.
Well, about to be 20-20.
And he hits the PAT.
Okay, so what do I gotta do now? I got 6 minutes. I don't think I'll be able to run out the clock and just kick a field goal, so it'd be more astute. And not get tackled behind the 20-yard line.
Anything going on their last possession, going 3 and out.
I'm going to spread it out a little bit. Go A spread. Start out with a dive play. six in the box.
And he's taken down 4, maybe 5 yards on the run.
Got to be careful here because I have a tendency to just run it all game. But they've been doing pretty good on defense stopping that, so I don't want to get too careless and just chuck the ball.
On this play, they sniffed that play out from the start.
It's third down and 6 to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. Number one lines up as a single back, drops back to pass, scrambling around, and now he's gonna run. Got some open field. Knocked out of bounds.
Knocked over that referee too, and that guy. Everybody's just falling over. Let's try a little play action here.
Setting up the play action. He's in trouble. Throw short. He's into the open field. He's knocked out of bounds.
That was close. They almost sacked me there.
Good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake as a real weapon against an aggressive defense like this.
You're right, Kirk. Those guys are swarming to where they think the ball is, then the ball is flying over their head.
Number one, alone in the backfield. They'll throw on first down.
Second and one, I'll dive it.
Ball right around midfield.
If I can get a good push and just get a couple yards.
And down he goes at the 48. Pick up of a yard for the tailback.
Okay.
The defense try again. Stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. Takes off attack. And he's taken down.
Try that play action again.
Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now.
Complete. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running
back. Go back to the dive.
Did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
And the quarterback did a tremendous job of the fake handoff, too.
He tries to spin. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Well, the offensive line needs third to do a better two. Job up front of opening the hole for the running back.
They line up for another third.
Try to get a fullback in here and get a lead block.
The Aggies come out in a two tight end set. Here's the give. And down he goes at the 37-yard line. They don't pick up the first on that play.
Brad, that defense is saying, not so fast, my friend. You're not going to run that ball that easy.
Fourth and one.
Controlling the line of scrimmage is crucial here.
Now.
Call for a timeout, and they've got two remaining.
I think I need to spread it out here. Alright.
Just get the first down and keep the drive alive.
Ohio State comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Nice play fake. Looks. Off his hand.
I waited too long to throw that ball.
That one just fell out of his hand.
In a coach's mind, there's no reason for that to ever happen. He has to make that catch.
The Aggie with 4 receivers. Drop back to pass. Looking. Looks like he's going to run with the spin. Gain of 9.
Third and one. I'll give it to the fullback. Run some people over now.
Texas A&M sets up in the eye. They'll try to power it. Fullback. And he's taken down. Gain of 1 yard by the fullback. 10. Ball on the 24. High formation here. They keep it on the ground with the tailback.
So stupid.
Tackled for a loss on the play. Kirk, they really had nothing going on that run.
I'll tell you what, Brad, it's almost like he ran into a brick wall on that play.
Second down, and they got 15 for the first down. This is the 16th play of this drive. The Aggies come out in the H formation, gets the ball. No, they fake. He catches another. A good pickup on the play action pass. So again, a third down as the offense lines up.
Or at least in field goal range, so.
Texas A&M goes with the ace set here.
I'm going to have to a decision to make if I don't make it here. But of course, the left side is open.
He decides to run with it. Spinning. And down he goes. And he goes over the century mark for that right there.
You know, Brad, he's had a great day, but credit the offensive line for fine blocking all game long.
It's first and 10, and this is the 18th play of the drive.
Got five in the box against my five. Should be a good run.
They'll give it off here.
Or not.
Texas A&M in a four wide set, back to pass. Lays one.
That was stupid.
Coach, you made a nice defensive play there.
Why did I do that?
He just stuck his hand out.
Probably should have bullet passed him.
Come out with four wide out. Drop back to pass. He's scrambling. And now he's going to run. And down he goes. An 8-yard gain.
Oh my God. Fourth and inches. Here we go, man. Here we go. Okay. Really thought I was going to get tackled there. Assuming I make this, this will give me a 7-point lead, and they'll have 1 minute and 37 score. Yes. That's it. Just got to keep it on the ground, manage the clock. Everybody.
And they'll have two remaining.
Give it to him again.
Second and two coming up here. Ball on the 42-yard line. Number one is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Here's the give.
Get out of my way.
And down he goes. Ohio State takes a timeout, and they'll have one timeout left. First and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. The Aggies line up with two tight ends. He has some room. He spins around. Gain of 9. EA Sports and Old Spice say congratulations to our players of the game. Texas A&M comes out with an I formation. They hit it off again, and he's going to lose yards on this one. Well, the defense really put the clamps down on that run.
Boy, Greg, great effort up front by that defense.
Ohio State calls a timeout, and now they got no timeouts left. 32 coming up here. Ball on the 25-yard line. Texas A&M comes out with two tight ends. And he's taken down. They denied him the first down on that run.
Brad, that's what I call a big-time effort by the defense.
The crowd boos, which, I mean, the crowd never boos at A&M, but make this a two-possession game, assuming I don't miss it, and I do, and it was a waste. I guess I should have gone for it.
Lines up as a single back. They'll throw on first down. Steps up. Going deep.
Interception.
Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. The defense really missed a golden opportunity there.
That's what separates a good player from a great player. When you have a chance like that, you need to take advantage of it.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 24. Texas A&M lines up in a dime defense here.
Oh my God, are you serious? Finally got it.
Nice catch by the receiver.
That reception put him over the century mark for the day. And you want to know something, Kurt?
What's that?
This receiver is the real deal. He's a great playmaker.
Well, if somebody's going to block a field goal, now's the time. Sure how to block it.
On the extra point. So we're down to just a few seconds remaining here in the ball game. And our score, Ohio State 27.
It is possible for me to win here. I don't have to go to overtime.
Here's the kick.
The safest thing to do would be to go to overtime.
Number 3 takes it at the 4. Spin move. Good coverage by the kicking team.
Yep. Beautiful job of playing their assignments right there.
First and 10. Ball on the 18. Number 1, alone in the backfield. Back to pass. He's looking. Here they come. And now he's going to improvise. He's not got around. And he threw that one into a nice game.
Brad, this is a spectacular play by the quarterback. He caught the defense napkin and he took it.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 40-yard line. Number 1.
See if somebody can break free here.
First down. Here comes the pressure.
Holy moly.
Looks like he's going to run. He picked up the first down on that one.
Brad, this kid can hurt you in so many ways, and he just showed one way right there.
One shot to the end zone.
This looks like their last shot to get it to the end zone.
Just what I said.
Looks, rolling out to the right side.
And intercepted. Oh. Oh. Oh my God. Yes. Ooh. Oh my God, that was crazy. Are you serious? Got to see that again. Fake toss. Not sure what that did, but okay. Thinking I'm going to get out to the right. I've got two guys on me. Chuck it out. I thought I was going to get intercepted. Number 13. Bats it down. I think it's over. But 83 is already on the way. Catches it. I'm thinking, okay. Maybe I can break a tackle here. Get one. Get in a sticky situation here. Pick up a block from 5. Number 13 has to run around. And now it's a race to see who can get the right angle. I thought maybe I was going to get tackled before. And I knocked the pylon, so that's a touchdown. Just barely. And the 12th man goes wild. Ceremonial touch, extra field, extra point here. And that'll do it. I played a way better game this time compared to last time. And I get the upset. The clone coaches meet, shake hands. Why do you look like me? I don't know.
They made some big plays on defense and capitalized on some key opportunities, and they ended up stealing this victory. What a nail biter.
Thanks for joining us for another presentation of NCAA Football 2004. And our final score on this one, Texas A&M 34, Ohio State 27. For Lee Corso, Kirk Herbstreit, and everyone at EA Sports, I'm Brad Nessler saying goodbye and see you next time.
You've just finished the number one greatest game of all time. Go to my NCAA Greatest Games to reflect on your accomplishments. Okay, let's see the stats. I got 24 first downs to their 12, 431 total offense. I think most of that was, or a lot of that was in the second quarter. At least the passing yards were. 59 rushing attempts, 254 on the ground. Completion, where I got 11 out of 16, two touchdowns. They got 10 out of 22, one touchdown. 177, we got almost the same passing yards. I got four sacks on them. Third down conversion kind of died down in the second half. It was 100% going in, and coming out it ended up at 66%, which is still pretty good. 12 out of 18, not bad. Theirs sunk down to 40%. Our fourth down conversion ratings were perfect. Perfect in the red zone. One turnover each. One fumble each, but I only lost one to their zero. I got one interception on them. I got 558 total yards to their 422. I got three penalties for 15. I got one for 5. And I definitely beat them in the time of possession. Almost 20 minutes. Let's see individual stats. Number 16. Who was number 16? This is 2004. I want to say Kendrick McNeil. I think it was Kendrick McNeil. Got a 202 rating, 11 out of 16. Two touchdowns, 68% completion. See, I'm not a big passer. I mean, I kind of picked up the passing there at the end, but I like to be efficient, kind of aim, be more precise. QBs are the same number. They got a 117 rating, 10 out of 22. That's sub 50. 45% completion rating, about the same passing yards. Number 16 got 149 rushing yards, followed by halfback number 1. Pretty good game. So they scored 3 points in the first quarter, 7 in the second, 3 in the third, and 14 in the fourth. So I outscored them in 3 quarters. Which leaves a total at 27-34 A&M. Right, guys, that's it for this stream. Hope you guys enjoyed it. I'll see you guys in the next one.